So yesterday, Chris Stuckman did a movie review for Drive. It was an in-depth analysis. And basically, he gave many different reasons why the film is fantastic and everything. And I decided, you know, there are so many peers of my age that hate this movie and think it's boring and stuff. So I decided, hey, I'm gonna step in. So let's do this. So Drive stars Ryan Gosling, Carey Mulligan, Albert Brooks, Ryan Cranston, Ron Perlman, and just some fantastic acting. It's directed brilliantly by Nicholas Winding Refn, who came from, what was it? It was in Australia, I don't quite remember, but he also directed Bronson with Tom Hardy, and Tom Hardy gave a fantastic performance in that movie. He directed a trilogy called The Pusher Trilogy, a crime drama trilogy. And, you know, the critics praised Drive. You know, despite having a big appearance at the Oscars, a lot of critics put it as their number one movie of the year, and it really got a lot of praise. But with audiences, not so much. Like I said, a lot of my peers said it was boring and gay, and they didn't like it. There wasn't enough action for their taste. You know, most of them did not really like it. And I admit, the first time I watched it, I was not a big fan of it. I liked it. I thought it was pretty good. And that was before I really grew a big appreciation for movies, you know, before watching Collateral. And then it came on Netflix for instant streaming, and I thought, hey, how about I give this another watch? Because I kind of liked it the first time. And, you know, the second time, I really started like it. I'm saying, hey, this is pretty spanking good. I'm starting to really like this. And so then, you know, after watching Collateral again and watching this analysis, I realized what I was missing. So I watched it again, and I am in love with this movie. I did not know how much I was missing. I mean, seriously, there is so much more to this movie than the average viewer would think. It's a fantastic movie with some of the most amazing cinematography, some great suspense in the scenes that have to do with, you know, the driver's job. And it's mostly about the driver. You don't know his name, he's kind of a mysterious character, but you really look deeper into it. There was so much detail, whether like the scorpion jacket and it all, everything, just anything that seems a little out of place, or any of the music, there's so many, all the details, they all have a purpose. That is the magic of this movie. It's what makes the movie pretty much perfect. You know, you think at first, artsy, art house, but you know what? Movies were originally art. I mean, they weren't always just entertainment. It was always an art. It was an art form. People started to love special effects and, you know, cool effects and stuff like that more than characters and the art and everything, and just like the plot and everything. And so that's really where it became, where we got movies like Independence Day rather than films like this. But you know, movies like this carry on that legacy, which is amazing. And I mean, this is one of the best films of the decade. I mean, honestly, it's a fantastic film. The performances are flawless, and I mean, Albert Brooks shows some dedication by, you know, shaving his eyebrows, trying to make himself look emotionless, but still giving this fantastic performance. And you know, and Ryan Gosling is what makes this movie, because you know, it's really driven by his characters and the details and, you know, the supporting cast, but he's what makes the movie. His performance is so solid, helps the details perfectly, and Nicholas Winding Refn definitely, how would I describe it? He definitely made a great decision. You know, he really communicated with Gosling and that, and you know, that proves that he's a great director, you know, from his cinematography, you know, his direction, and just the way he communicates with his actors to bring the best in them. Now, Ron Perlman is in a lot of, like, bad movies. I mean, he was in The Scorpion King 3, The Battle for Redemption or something like that. And also Alien Resurrection. I mean, I don't know what he does in those movies, but he is in some great movies like this, you know. And he, I've never seen Sons of Anarchy, but I heard he was good. And he was in Hellboy, which I thought it was a great superhero movie, developed on by Guillermo del Toro. And this is probably his best performance. He works so good along with Albert Brooks and Bryan Cranston, you know, the more experienced actors. Well, you know, you get some fantastic younger actors like Ryan Gosling and Carey Mulligan, this little kid that plays her son, his name's like Benicio or something like that. Can't quite remember. He does good too. And I mean, a lot of people say the violence is unnecessary. Here's the thing, it really isn't. I mean, there's a spoiler alert, the part in the elevator, a lot of people thought, why is this kid slow motion? Why is he smashing his brains out? It's because throughout the movie, from the opening scene to the ending, he is trying to live a normal life. He's not into this criminal life, and he doesn't like that. He wants to live a normal life, and he feels like Carey Mulligan and her son are the only way out. When he finds out about her husband getting into all this crime and everything, he gets mad, and this is the last time he's ever going to see her in this elevator, so the kiss has to be very uplifting and emotional. And then when he goes and smashes that guy's brain out, who's an assassin of a senpai, Albert Brooks, I believe. Yeah, he was senpai, one of the bad guys, I'm just going to say. I mean, he is just, he's taking all of his anger out on him because he's mad. And that's why. I mean, he's taking all of his anger. And it makes sense once you really start to think about it. And that's where the complaint comes out. Well, why are movies have to be so deep? Why can't they just be entertainment? Because movies were originally art and they're living on the legacy. And the little action suspense that's in this movie is incredible. I mean, the car chase that's halfway through the movie is amazing. And the part with all the blood and that whole motel room, awesome. The opening scene, a lot like Transporter, but still, what are you gonna do? Who cares? And you know, some people were questioning, why does he just stand, spoiler alert, another spoiler, people wonder why he just went up to that door of Ron Perlman's restaurant and just stood there and just walked away. Well, you see, the movie's like, Ryan Gosling is a stuntman for films, and he's sort of starting to realize that he had this connection with movies and stories. And so he goes there, and he's like overdramatic and everything. I mean, it's kind of hard to explain, but watch Chris Duckman's analysis, and it'll definitely make sense to you. But that's why he's starting to see his life as a film. And I love that it has some sort of connection to, like, real filmmaking. It's awesome. That's why he killed, spoiler alert, Ron Perlman in that overdramatic way. I mean, you know, he's just brutally hurting him on the beach, and then, you know, just kills him in the ocean. It's like, yeah, it's supposed to be that way. It makes sense once you really think. It's a really, it's just this ordinary art house drama, action kind of movie, crime drama, but with a lot more thought-provoking elements that you would never think of. Like, you know, just his part of the turtleneck, I forget what it's called, you know, just that being tucked down in these scenes of just emotion and everything, just those little details that I said before. There's so much more in this movie than you normally think of. So yes, do I love Drive Now? Yes, it showed me, and Chris Duckman, the guy who inspired me to do movie reviews, showed me that there's so much more to a movie. To a movie like Drive, and the magic of this movie is phenomenal. It's slowly becoming one of my favorite movies. It's probably not going to make it into my top 20, but I mean, come on, it's a fantastic movie. You know, if you really just think hard, and you know, just, well, don't laugh, please. Sorry, I just ruined the whole thing. Oh my gosh. But if you just look into it more, and you will find something incredible, like a treasure, and you will love this movie. I'm being so deep right now. Just please check out Drive, give it a chance, please. I'm gonna give Drive 5 out of 5 stars. It may not be original in the opening scene, and it might take a little bit to understand its awesomeness, but once you do, it's pretty much perfect. So, thank you for watching this video. I really hope you liked it. And thank you to, what was his name again? Dakface. Dude, thank you for asking me to do this. You know, I appreciate it when people want me to do these videos. It's awesome. You know, thank you, Chris Duckman, for just basically getting me to love this movie and inspiring me to do these videos. And I really hope the rest of you love this or like this video. So, thank you for watching, and so long.